Once again, the RHS timed Chelsea Flower Show to perfection. It was beautiful sunshine the whole week of the show. Chelsea normally goes ahead in May, but had to be postponed this year due to COVID. However, the usual show week saw torrential downpours in London, so it was just as well it moved. So we're here at Chelsea Flower Show. We've donated some of our stone into one of the container gardens designed by Ellie Edkins. So we're going to go and check it out and see how she's getting on. The hot tin roof garden was definitely our favourite of the container gardens. And we aren't just saying that because our stone was used. We loved the fabulous beach vibes within the garden, as well as all the lush green planting. We had a chat with Ellie to find out more about her design.
So, talk us through the garden.
So, this garden is inspired by a life lived by the beach, and kind of, so it's got a lot of coastal influences. The main one being this corrugated silk cladding and also this material used on the planters, which is quite reminiscent, hopefully, of a kind of surf shack, kind of beachy vibe. But then in contrast to that, all the planting feels quite cool and shady, so all the planting we've got here is suitable for a shady environment. Most of it's evergreen too, so that's kind of a nice little add-on as well.
It's beautiful, lush
Thank
greenery,
you.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hopefully you can cut that a little bit out.
Yes, we could have cut it out, but we didn't. The corrugated steel pots within the garden were all designed by Ellie herself and created specifically for the show. Due to the huge amounts of interest she's had in them, she's considering making it a sideline business. All the container gardens were beautifully unique and built by Big Fish Landscapes. White limestone gravel also featured in the A Tranquil Space in the City, designed by Mika Misawa. Inspired by Japanese culture, everything in this garden was specifically positioned and faced a certain way for a reason. We spotted Adam Frost, chilling out in the IBC Pocket Garden, designed by Sarah Edwards. And we were blown away by the vibrant colour tones in the Pop Street Garden, which initially, we have to admit, we thought was a shop. However, on closer inspection, the fabulous pop culture references became clear. Finally, the last of the container gardens was the Stolen Soul Garden, which couldn't fail to impress with its beautiful living walls. This garden was designed by Anna Dabrowska-Jowdy and drew attention to invisible mental health issues. Just along from the container gardens were the artisan gardens. There were only two of them this year, and we were particularly fond of the Blue Diamond Forge Garden, as it features an actual working forge, which has been inspired by a National Trust-owned 15th century forge in Devon. A selection of larger boulders and rockery stone create a stunning natural garden that looks like it has been there for years. Another garden that we couldn't believe had been specially created for the show was a Bodmin Jail 60 degrees east, a garden between continents. It was designed by Ekaterina Zaskukina and Carly Kershaw and featured moss-covered boulders alongside a beautiful, vibrant planting scheme. We also did some celeb spotting and enjoyed watching Monty Don doing his bit to camera, although there were several interruptions by helicopters and planes. The Gangzhou China Garden won Best in Show and received a gold medal. We can see why, as the garden immediately transported us to foreign lands, helped by the sunshine, which cast incredible shadows around the garden from the intricate wooden sculptures. A selection of boulders were used to break up the planting and bring a natural feel to the space. Feature boulders were also present in the M&G Garden, designed by Harris Bug Studio. The garden emphasises the importance of green spaces in an urban environment, and featured a range of autumnal plants that were a perfect fit for the season. The Sanctuary Gardens also had some incredible spaces. Our favourite was Bible Society Psalm 23, designed by Sarah Eberly. We thought the use of boulders to create the incredible water feature was inspired, and really wanted to cool off in the pond, lined with what looked like Scottish pebbles and cobbles. This garden won a very well-deserved gold medal. Another sanctuary garden that we loved was the Finnish Soul Garden, which also had a very inviting pond. It is designed to be a seaside garden that is used as a recreational facility by city dwellers, which we think is a very interesting concept. This garden received a silver gilt medal. Another new category for this year were the balcony gardens. They were all styled very differently and did a great job of showing what was achievable in an incredibly small space. We really enjoyed Autumn Chelsea and actually found it a refreshing change from the spring version. However, we are still super excited to visit in spring next year too. Thank you for watching our RHS Chelsea Flower Show 2021 video, and please subscribe for more videos.